Turning to congressional races, starting with Ohio. Swing districts like the 1st District on Cincinnati's west side could make or break the GOP's hope of retaking control of the House.
And making Westchester Republican John Boehner the House Speaker. News 5's John London is live downtown with the Battle of the Steves. John.
Yeah, Driehaus and Chabot, both of them will be downtown tonight for the vote count. Steve Chabot will be here at the Hyatt where we are now. They share a first name and a heartfelt love of the West Side, but that's where they part company. Politically, they are philosophically different in terms of their views about the 1st District.
As we watched voters in the 1st District today,
how are you today?
I'm good. How about yourself?
We also observed an America in microcosm.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Two candidates who reflect the divide that defines much of the nation.
We've seen a leftward lurch in this country, and I think a lot of people think we need to pull it back to the conservative side.
You know, they've got a clear choice here. We either go back to the failed policies of the Bush administration or we move forward.
Two of their student volunteers are working the issues door to door. Pat Schlembach on the left is part of the Driehaus ground game. Sean Cahill on the right is in the Chabot camp. Xavier sophomores caught up in a whirlpool race that has spun national interest.
I really felt energized by the amount of attention.
We definitely felt the national presence.
They are part of Gene Beaupre's mass media and politics class.
I'm a firm believer that all politics is local politics, and things can be happening nationally, but it's door to door when it comes to the real politics.
Which is why both Steves in the 1st District rely so heavily on people like Pat and Sean.
It's very polarized. There will be those who will willingly say, voting the whole Democratic ticket, and then there will be those who are saying, I'm not voting this year because I'm not happy with what's happened.
We're in kind of an area that doesn't know its political identity right now. It's been Republican in the past, but in 08 it went Democrat. So I think in the eyes of the nation, Ohio and even the 1st Congressional District would be a great indicator of where this country is to go in the next few years.
And those young students are nursing some sore knuckles by now. They've knocked on doors 100 at a time in this campaign. Sometimes on a daily basis, hoping to be difference makers in what is a very diverse 1st District. Reporting live downtown, John London, News 5.